Hello everyone, this is Tom from everystepphysics.com, everystepcalculus.com. I'm going to do a problem concerning parametric equations in this video. And let's do it. Index 8 to get to my menu. I'm already scrolled down from the upper bottom to parametric equations here. Save time. It says that when you enter it, if you don't have Z, parameter for Z, then you just put a zero down. You have to press alpha before you enter anything in these entry lines. You're going to press alpha 2 times T minus 5. And for the Y, we're going to put alpha 3 times T plus 9. And for the Z of T, we're going to put 0. I always show you which vector. This is a vector now. See, these arrows are make it a vector. Shows you that it is a vector. And I gave you an option to change it if you made a mistake. We say it's okay here. And we can do several things with that. For instance, sketch by hand. We can take these. And here's what I'm using for the T parameter, 0, minus 1, minus 2, and then 1 and 2. When you enter those into the equations that we entered at the beginning, minus becomes x minus 9 and y is 3, minus 7 and 6, minus 5 and 9. If you plot these points, minus 3 and 12, minus 1 and 15, if you plot these points, you're going to have some sort of straight line like this, and you'll be able to show your on your test how that is graphed. That's generally what they do in a test. So we can go back and get more calculations. For instance, we want to know the angle of that line. The angle is computed if you take the derivative of the x and y components, and then remember, the first derivative is velocity, and then we use arctangent to find that. So here's the derivative of the x and y functions. Here's the angle is 56.31 degrees. We can also eliminate the parameter number 5. We're taking out the T now. So we solve for T with X equals this, and then we, and T is, then becomes this when we solve for T. And we substitute that into the equation here. And I have quotation marks. You got to put parentheses around this. That's where you're substituting in for. And it turns out to be 1.5X plus 16.5. Notice this is mx plus b, really, the equation for a tangent line, 1.5x. So 1.5 would be the slope.